Hello viewers, today we're going to talk about that red battery warning light every car has. If everything's fine, it will illuminate when you turn on the ignition and go off once the engine is running. But what if that doesn't happen and this warning light stays on? Or what if it suddenly pops up while driving down the road? Well, that's exactly what we're going to answer in this video by learning what the red battery warning light means and what may cause it to stay on. Moreover, we'll explain how to quickly diagnose and fix the problem. But before all that, make sure to subscribe and hit that notification button. As you're probably guessing, a red battery warning light indicates a battery or charging related issue. And the backbone of this system is made from two components, the alternator and the battery. Despite their different sizes and configurations, all automotive batteries have the same job. First, they store electricity that powers up various electrical components while the car is turned off. This includes the anti-theft alarm, remote locking, or interior lights, among many other things. But more importantly, the battery has to hold enough charge for the starter to successfully crank the engine when you turn on the ignition. With the car running, its alternator takes over the role of the primary power source. This engine-driven device generates a strong and steady flow of electricity which powers up all of the car's electrical devices. Some of the things that rely on it are the ignition system, headlights, power windows, and various electrical heaters. In addition, the alternator continuously tops up the battery so it's fully charged once the car is turned off. Lastly, the alternator, battery, and the rest of the car's electrical systems are connected with several wires. In most cars, these are thick red and black cables running from the alternator to the battery or are attached somewhere on the chassis.
So, having learned the charging system theory, it's now time to go over the most likely failure points.
The alternator is driven by an auxiliary belt or, as many call it, a serpentine belt. Being made from rubber, these belts may become brittle with time and eventually break apart. When this happens, there will be nothing left to drive the alternator, meaning an electrical charge is not being generated. From that moment on, all of the car's electrics will live on the limited power supply from the battery, which will usually run out within a few minutes. If your belt has snapped, you may also notice several other symptoms, such as loss of power steering or air conditioning. And even if it's intact and in good shape, the tensioner that holds it firmly against the pulleys may be weak, which results in a belt slip. Next, we have the alternator, which, with only one moving part, is a simple device. But even as such, it has several failure points that may make it completely inoperable. For a start, that one moving part, the rotor, and the stator coil wrapped around it can get mechanically damaged. This usually happens when the alternator gets continuously covered by leaking coolant or oil, which acts as an adhesive for dirt and other contaminants. With time, this forms buildups on which the rotor rubs against as it rotates inside the stator. Next, at the front of the alternator, we have a pulley on which the serpentine belt sits. In many cases, this component is made from one piece of metal milled into this specific shape. Some cars, however, have a so-called overrunning alternator pulley with an internal mechanism that allows it to engage or disengage when needed. Should this mechanism break in any way, it will have the same effect as a broken auxiliary belt. The rotor has a pair of copper rings at its back side, from where two carbon brushes pick up generated electricity. To ensure sufficient contact and electric conductivity, these brushes are pushed against the ring surface with springs. Sometimes the brush may jam within the housing, which stops it from touching the ring and prevents electricity flow. If that happens, carefully tapping the alternator with a hammer could solve the problem. Lastly, there is a regulator at the alternator's back end. This is a simple electronic device with three diodes inside. Its job is to transform the AC current generated by the alternator into a steady flow of 12 volt DC electricity. If broken, this component may cut the power supply from the alternator. In addition, a faulty regulator may cause voltage spikes, which have a devastating effect on cars' sensitive electronics. As previously explained, The alternator, battery, and the rest of the car's electrical system are interconnected with several cable wires. Each wire has a clamp or ring connector at each end, with bolts or nuts holding them firmly against the component to which it connects. For instance, we have positive and negative cable clamps fitted on the battery's terminals. It's much the same with a grounding strap that attaches to the car's chassis or the positive wire cable connected to the alternator. Nuts and bolts that hold them in place, if not tightened up correctly, may become loose, which breaks up the electric circuit. Sometimes, one of the battery's terminals may be covered with a thick layer of white, powdery substance. This is usually referred to as battery corrosion and is, in most cases, caused by hydrogen or acid leak. If in contact with metal battery terminals, these escaping gases will cause chemical reactions and form those buildups we mentioned earlier. And if substantial enough, these may increase electrical resistance or even completely cut off the current flow. Lastly, there is always a possibility the battery itself is faulty, which could obstruct the charging process. Let's take traditional flooded batteries as an example, as these don't cope well with deep discharging. So if you've accidentally left the headlights or radio on overnight, it could have flattened out the battery. And as a result, one or more of its cells may have deformed and short-circuited. Besides preventing the battery from holding its charge, this may also mess up with the whole electrical system.
If having a red battery light on your dashboard, you'll want to quickly find out what's causing the problem. And my advice here is to start with things that are easy to check first.
With that in mind, pop up the hood and check the auxiliary belt, which you'll find on the timing side of the engine. A functioning belt has to be in one piece without any visible cracks and neatly wrapped around all surrounding pulleys. While at it, check the belt's firmness by pressing it with your finger. New auxiliary belts are, in most cases, priced in the $50 region. And with prices above $100, belt tensioners are a bit more expensive. But in most cars, replacing the belt and tensioner is an easy job that you can do by yourself. Next, check the battery and its terminals for any traces of corrosion. This will be a white, powder-like substance, which usually forms thick buildups on battery's positive terminal. While this looks nasty, cleaning it off is an easy job. All that is needed is some baking soda, which you'll pour onto the corrosion buildups, and a toothbrush soaked into warm water to scrub it off. And the best thing is, this simple fix won't cost you anything. If battery corrosion wasn't the issue, checking all connection points may be the next logical step. This includes the clamps on the battery's terminals, grounding straps, and the cable that connects to the alternator's post. For this, you'll need a ratchet and appropriately sized sockets. And as with baking soda and a toothbrush, you won't have any expenses here. Lastly, you can do the voltage test to check the battery and the alternator. This is a simple procedure that only requires an ordinary multimeter. Start by hooking up the multimeter's probes to the battery's negative and positive terminals while the car is not running. With a good battery, you should see readings at around 12 volts. Next, fire up the engine and check the voltage once more. If the alternator is working correctly, you should see at least 13 volts. Anything below that would suggest a failing alternator. In addition, any voltage over 15 volts is not acceptable either, as this may damage sensitive electronical components.
So that's all about the car charging system for today. I hope these explanations helped you figure out what's causing your red battery light to stay on, and that you managed to fix the problem with some of the troubleshooting steps presented here. If so, give us a big thumbs up on this video and subscribe to our channel. But if none of this hasn't helped, your car probably has a much deeper electrical issue. In that case, visit our website or check out our other videos here for more detailed car repair guides.